Okay, so you know how in Bluey, Chattermax is like totally a Furby, but like obviously to get around copyright and to invent their own like in-world meta, it's not a Furby, it's Chattermax. I was like, well, what if there was a Chattermax Furby? So I skinned a Furby. It didn't work. This was my brother's childhood toy, which sounds like I'm an awful sister, but it didn't work, and I asked his permission. So I have this, and I have this, and this is definitely, like I said earlier, I trust the process. We're gonna be harvesting this fur to get all the colors because Chattermax has a lot of different things going on. We're gonna be using this as a template, and then we're going to be skinning a Furby that actually does work into Chattermax. So I hope y'all will stick around for the process because honestly, I want a Chattermax in my life, and I know my daughter does too, so let's make one. Hello, my everythings, and welcome back to making a Chattermax Furby from Bluey. The first thing I'm going to do is make the party mode, dance mode feathers. I'm attaching them where the original Furby ears go, and I'm using this sparkle felt for some extra pizzazz. My goal is to keep all of the Furby functionality, but make it Chattermax. So I'm going to stitch this up here, and you can see me doing a test on my original Furby. And after we add some sparkle gems, that's what we have for part two. Hello, my everything. And welcome back to part three of the Bluey Chattermax Furby build. We're in the final stretch of the creative decision making and the end of the pattern making phase. This is the last bit we have to figure out, and then it's just going to be putting it together. So, in default mode, Chattermax has these pink and teal alternating feathers that hang out right on or above his eye. Of course, in party mode, the big purple feathers pop up, but we did those in the last video, so those are already thought out. Now, what I cannot decide is if I want those default feathers to be mounted to the eyelash and move with the Furby eye, or if I want them to just be stationary. Now, if I was really worried about like strict accuracy, I would probably just put them on the head and be like, yeah, that's good. But remember, I am trying to keep Furby functionality and also just kind of some Furby flavor in this. And so I'm thinking about making them move and putting them on the eyelash. What do y'all think? Do you think I should do moving eyelash feathers or stationary eyelash feathers? Let me know. Hello, my everythings. Time for the Chattermax from Bluey Furby custom part. We're all ready. So using my Millennium Furby, who I will never cut up, as a model, I just want to show y'all where we are. Mode, dance mode, ears. You can see them with the sparkles. So I have another one. It's drying, so I'm not gonna pick that one up. We just finalized kind of the decision on the eyelash feather. And then on top of that, we are gonna do the stationary Chattermax normal default mode feathers. So let me get those on and I'll show y'all. There we go. So we have dance mode, default mode, and then we're gonna come in for all of y'all that voted in my poll on the moving or the stationary eyelid. Thank you so much. I wanted to do both, and that's kind of where the consensus was going, was definitely something moving and then both if I could swing it. So
okay, so I just gave him the trim and the little petals, and I think I love it even more.